Meghan Markle and Prince Harry reveal their plan to stay positive in new message. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex are hoping to spread positivity online. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have updated their fans about their plan for March, revealing on Instagram that they are hoping to continue to follow only positive news online. The royal couple posted a message on their account, telling their followers that they continue to follow only one other page, which is Thank Good News, who post about inspiring events that happen around the world. Prince Harry and Meghan wrote, "Happy 1st of March, everyone. This month, we continue on the good news path and are pleased to be following at Thank Good News, as a reminder of all of the good that is happening in the world. We hope it uplifts and inspires you." The couple's followers were quick to comment, with one writing, "Fantastic. Keep up, I love seeing all the great content to uplift others," while another wrote, "More kindness is always welcome." A third added, "What a beautiful thing to wake up to, thank you." The royal couple also shared a second post on Instagram shortly afterwards, to wish their followers a happy St. David's Day. Prince Harry and Meghan posted a number of pictures of themselves from a visit to Wales, and wrote, "Dydd gwael day we hapus." Wishing all of our Welsh followers a happy St. David's Day. Harry has been in the UK for the past few days to carry out some final engagements as a senior working member of the royal family. The dad of one hosted a summit for tourists on Wednesday in Edinburgh, where he unveiled a new holiday scheme to help tourists pick environmentally friendly flights. At the launch, the royal took to the stage to deliver a speech, and was asked how he should be addressed by host Aisha Hazarika. She revealed that he had asked to be simply addressed by his first name. She told delegates, "He's made it clear that we are all just to call him Harry. So ladies and gentlemen, please give a big, warm, Scottish welcome to Harry." On Friday, meanwhile, Harry met Jon Bon Jovi at Abbey Road Studios in London, to record a special single in aid of the Invictus Games Foundation. While Harry has been in the UK, Meghan has stayed in Canada, where the couple have been living for the past month, with their baby son Archie. With the Sussexes due to officially step back as senior royals from 31 March, it's not clear at this stage when they will make public appearances in future. Royal sources have said that the couple will be in the UK regularly as they plan to split their time between here and North America. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry shot themselves in the foot with abrasive comments. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry have been warned they shot themselves in the foot with the release of an abrasive statement about the use of their Sussex royal brand once they step down. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry last week released a lengthy statement unveiling some details of the new system they will be abiding by once the step away from their royal duties at the end of March. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex confirmed they agreed to give up their Sussex royal brand despite investing in building up their social media presence under the trade name. Royal family expert Katie Nicol warned the statement came off as abrasive and claimed Meghan and Harry shot themselves in the foot with their comments. Speaking to True Royalty TV, Ms. Nicol said, "I just wonder if issuing a big, lengthy statement like that. I think it is abrasive in parts. I just don't understand why they do that. Because then they feed that narrative of a rift in the media, and why do it? You've shot yourself in the foot. Even if you privately feel that way, be quiet about it publicly." The Duke and Duchess of Sussex had previously lamented the public pressure they have been facing since marrying in 2018 and suggested plans to step away from their royal duties would help them keep a more private, and lower, profile. But Ms. Nicol suggested the latest statement the couple issued indicated a certain degree of unhappiness with the strategy the royal family adopted to help the Duke and Duchess of Sussex ease out of their royal career. She continued, "It struck me as slightly abrasive. It didn't strike me as, we've sorted everything out, this feels very smooth and we're happy with how everything is." When you look at the statement that was released earlier on in the week, the rumors of them losing the ability to use royal, "if you wanted to just put something out that felt very anodyne and yes, we're going along with this, we're very, very happy to do it," you'd have sent something out quite different. The royal commentator added, "It's interesting to hear from them directly and I think it was very useful because we're not used to getting these lengthy statements. In that respect, it was quite an interesting insight into how they feel, how they thought it was going to work. But to me it, I thought this is a couple who doesn't feel particularly happy about how this has been handled. In the statement released last week, the Duke and Duchess confirmed they agreed to give up the brand despite insisting Her Majesty has no jurisdiction for the exclusive use of the word royal. Meghan and Harry said, "While there is not any jurisdiction by the monarchy or cabinet office over the use of the word royal overseas, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex do not intend to use Sussex royal or any iteration of the word royal in any territory, either within the UK or otherwise, when the transition occurs spring 2020. However, the Companies Act 2006 strictly regulates the use of all royal insignia, arms and images relating to the royal family as well as the use of names associated with the royal family. The Act prohibits companies, including overseas companies, and limited liability partnerships from being registered under a name which includes any of the sensitive words, included within a list of restricted names or expressions. The regulation includes the terms royal, queen, king, prince, and princess. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex last year made dozens of trademark applications at the Intellectual Property Office, IPO, under their proposed Sussex Royal Foundation's name but have since withdrawn their request.